Hello everyone, myself Anand Dwivedi. Welcome you all to the e-learning platform of St. Michael Academy, Bethia. Today, we are going to start the first chapter of history of class 10. The name of the chapter is The Rise of Nationalism in Europe. The chapter begins with an image which is made by Frédéric Soriot. Frédéric Soriot made 4 images in year 1848. In those 4 images, he visualized a world of his dream. The world of the dream of Frédéric Soriot has been made by a group of countries who are democratic and republic. In the first image, which you can see just behind me, there are people of America and Europe. They are in a long queue. They are passing through the Statue of Liberty. As you know, a Statue of Liberty is a representation for liberty and freedom. In this image, we can see different types of people, women, children, and people of all status. They are in this line and they are offering homage to a Statue of Liberty. The Statue of Liberty is an image of a female lady which represents laws and enlightenment. As you see, in one hand of this statue, there is an enlightenment torch, while in the other hand, there is a charter of rights which were given to the people. You have studied about French Revolution. The same thing was there. People also considered law as a women figure. If we see this image carefully, we find that in front of this Statue of Liberty, there are remains of absolutist governance. The scattered remains can be seen clearly. Their fragments are scattered here and there. The world about which Soriot has imagined is an utopian world. Utopian means a world which cannot exist in reality because it is so ideal. So, in the world of Soriot Utopia, the people are divided into a number of distinct countries and they all have come together in this queue. They all are offering homage to liberty and equality. We can recognize these people by their flags and their costumes, the clothes they are wearing. The long queue depicts different types of flags, and these flags represent different countries. The countries who are leading this procession are United States of America and Switzerland, because at that time they had become a nation state. We can recognize France. It has just reached the statue and its recognition is from its tricolor which it has. France is followed by the people of Germany bearing the flag red, black and gold. It is very interesting that at the time of making this print, German people did not exist as United Nations. Following the German people, there are people of Austria, the Kingdom of Two Sicilies, Lombardy, Poland, England, Ireland, Hungary and Russia. From the heaven, Jesus Christ, angels, different saints, they are gazing on this scene. They are surprised to see the changes which was taking place at that time. During 19th century, nationalism emerged as a force which brought many changes in political and mental world of Europe. The result of such changes came in the form of emergence of nation state, which was earlier either monarchy or dictatorship in different parts of Europe. The concept of dictatorship or monarchy was completely different from the concept of nation-state. Nation-state was one in which majority of the citizens, not only the rulers, come together to form a commonness among them and they used to share the common history. This commonness did not exist from time immemorial. It was forged by the struggles of leaders and common people. In this chapter, we will look the diverse actions, struggles and events which took place in different parts of Europe, which forced national state. We will look at the diverse processes through which national state and nationalism came into being in 19th century.